More now on the alarming rise in COVID infections among healthcare workers in Victoria. Cases doubling in just 2 weeks. Dr. Mukesh Haikerwal joins us from the COVID-19 testing clinic he's working at in Melbourne. Good morning to you.
Good morning. Thank you very much for having me on.
So, Doctor, right now you've got 994 healthcare workers who have the virus, nearly half are nurses. Why are so many getting sick?
It's a really dire situation. Since this whole crisis started, very much, if you remember back in early March, we were calling out then for access to good protective equipment. That means masks, that means gowns, that means gloves. It means visors, so that when you got your gloves and your masks on, you got another layer of protection. The problem is it's very patchy. Over the weekend, we had about 50 anaesthetists from the Australian Society of Anaesthetists and a whole bunch of GPs from GPs Down Under coming through to our practice to actually come and get some free charity-delivered shields, visors, to keep them safe. That's ridiculous that we have to do it that way. We don't get gloves, we don't get masks, and our people have that, depending on which hospital they're in, which organisation they're in, they do or they don't have it. That's wrong. These people are on the front line. They actually are now getting sick. We don't want 25 to 30% of our teams to go down. We want to be able to be providing care for our people, not just for COVID, but for the general health that they have to maintain. And it's really important that we get the equipment so our people stay safe.
Sounds like you're pretty mad about it.
I'm, you know, I actually have been trying to do this. Somebody said to me, how are you going? I said, I'm fine, I'm just tired. I'm not tired of doing the work. I'm not tired of looking after my people. I'm not tired of advocating for them. I'm tired because nobody's listening. We still can't have one place that you can go to get a result. There's 24 different labs around the country. If you get a result, a test done for this, you don't actually know where to go for it. We often don't get the results going back to the GP. You don't know who's doing what. You're not getting told about contact tracing. And actually, people are getting contact traced 23, 24 days after they're supposed to be cleared, which is day 14. The whole thing is really outrageous. And we've got really strong rules in Victoria. We're locking down. We've had a week of curfew. We've had another, level threes before that. And the numbers are starting to come down, not far enough, by the way. We went up to over 700. Yesterday was the worst single day for deaths in this state, in this country. Not acceptable. The number of people who are in hospital, really high. Not acceptable. You don't want to get to ICU, and when you want to get to ICU, you want to make sure you've got people there to look after you. So there's many issues here. Number one, look after your staff. Number two, make sure they've got proper equipment. Make sure it's across the whole state, every aspect of this. And make sure that you actually have a good registering system, a good database to make sure the distance, you can get hold of the results. So when you need them, you've got them.
So I tell you what, you're not mincing your words this morning, are you? The responsibility for this falls on who?
This is something that we all have to take some responsibility for. But the people that provide the services and the equipment to hospitals are the governments of Australia, the state government and the federal government. Our respiratory clinic has been provided for by the federal government, but we work in the state. We employ people in the state. We're actually all Victorians. So we should actually be part of the system. And what's happening is because we happen to have a funding line from federal, they don't think we exist. And it's got to stop. They've got to work with the doctors, they've got to work with the nurses, they've got to work with all the other healthcare providers to keep them safe so they can look after Victorians, look after Australians, and make sure that we support the Australian people, the Victorian people who are staying at home. They are doing the right thing. They are making sure they get tested. But we've got to support the other side of the equation now. We've done our bit as Victorians, we've done our bit as Australians, governments have got to do their bit and make sure that we look after the people that employ people and care for people every day in our backyards.
So it sounds like there's been a massive breakdown in communication, because we're hearing this morning one in five doctors and nurses say they have limited or in some cases no access to face masks, but then the government comes out and says, no, supply is fine, it's not an issue. Clearly the two sides are not working here together, and the result of this is that we have nearly 1,000 nurses and doctors, healthcare workers, off the job at the moment. These are doctors and nurses who are now not manning our hospitals.
That's absolutely right, and it's actually in the community too. the people in general practice, and we've had GPs in intensive care, have been there faceline looking after people. We all worry about COVID, and COVID is something that we are very much focused on. But it's not COVID that's going to kill people on its own. There's other diseases. Heart disease is still our number one killer. We're not getting people in to be looked after so they don't get to that level. And in order to do that, we've got to be safe. You've got to keep people masked up, gowned up. And, you know, the whole system of health is so important to us to keep us a vibrant, functioning economy in the future. If we let our guard down now and don't look after the health of people, Australians, of Victorians, if we don't look after the health of the healthcare workers who look after them, we really are in hiding to nowhere.
Yeah, well, we heard it there just straight from a hard-working GP that it's not good enough. Mikesh, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Appreciate it.